Occasionally, you'll come across a book that not only changes how you garden for the better, but also changes how you think about gardening for the better. And this is one of those books, Teeming with Microbes by Jeff Lowenfels and Wayne Lewis. And this is definitely a book you should have in your library. Join me today as I review it and tell you about some of the amazing information that's in this great book. Hi, I'm Gardener Scott, a master gardener who discusses everything gardening so that you can become a better gardener. And as you travel on that journey, I think it's important that you establish your own library of the best gardening books, and Teeming with Microbes should definitely be part of that library. It's very easy to go online and watch a video to see how to do something. That's great. But to really have success and to really grow as a gardener, it's beneficial to understand why you're doing what you're doing and how to have success based on understanding things like soil. And that's what this book is about. It's all about soil and the microbes in your soil. Now, note the title of the book. We all know that soil, healthy soil, is filled with organisms. It's teeming with life. But they made a play on the word in the title of this book. Not teeming with microbes, like having a whole lot of microbes, but teeming. Joining up with the microbes. And that's an important aspect that this book brings out to help you towards gardening success. If you work with your soil and encourage those organisms, you're much more likely to have that gardening success. There's a lot of science in this book. In fact, part one is called The Basic Science. And we're talking about soil, of course. Well, don't let that put you off from considering this book, because it's very easy to read and very easy to understand. In fact, it was a winner of the Garden Writers Association Gold Award for Best Book Writing. And it brings to mind some really easy to comprehend ideas. Like on the first page of chapter one, it gets you to remember that children's song about there was an old lady who swallowed a fly. I don't know why she swallowed a fly. I guess she'll die. And the song continues to the old lady swallowing a spider to eat the fly. And then she swallows a bird to eat the spider, and so on and so forth, all the way up to the old lady eating a horse. Well, the reason they bring to mind that children's song is because they're explaining how the soil food web works. All of those organisms within the soil, from bacteria to earthworms, it's important to understand their relationship, because the little ones are food for the bigger ones, and the bigger ones are food for the biggest ones. It's those kind of examples that really make it easy to understand some of this really in-depth science when it comes to understanding soil. And there's much more to a successful garden than just the soil and the soil organisms. There's the relationship between plants and the soil, and the authors do a great job of explaining that. Through photosynthesis, the energy goes to the plants to grow, but a large portion of that energy is going to the roots. And the roots then secrete carbohydrates, sugars, into the soil. And that benefits a lot of the soil organisms. Those exudates are what help bind up the soil and then feed those organisms. And at the rhizosphere, which is the point where the roots meet the soil, all of this is taking place. Well, it's all explained in the book, and you saw how easy it was for me to tell you about it. It might not be fully comprehensible, but when you read the book, little by little, it all starts to make sense how plants and soil and all these organisms work together to have success in the garden. And there's a lot more than just the broad relationships between all of these creatures and plants. There are separate chapters for a lot of these individual organisms. There's a chapter on bacteria. There's a chapter on archaea. Do you even know what archaea is? I didn't until I read this book. A chapter on fungi, a chapter on earthworms and arthropods, a chapter on protozoa, and a chapter on nematodes, and a chapter on gastropods. Those are the snails and the slugs in your garden. Lots of individual creatures that are covered in depth as they relate to soil and plants and your garden. So, there's no way I can know all of this, but I know enough from reading this book to understand a lot of those important factors. And I refer to this book regularly. That's why I suggest you add it to your library. In many of my previous videos, I've discussed how soil is the key to garden success. Well, I know that from reading Teeming with Microbes. And then when I discover something new in my soil or new in my garden that relates to the soil and I'm not sure exactly how it all fits in, well, I come back to this book to help really give me the information I'm looking for. The authors are really trying to help you become a better gardener with this book because it's not just about the science and the organisms within the soil. There's also a lot of good basic gardening information in this book. There's a chapter about compost and vermicompost, a chapter about mulch, a chapter about mycorrhizal fungi, a chapter about compost tea, a chapter about maintaining your trees and shrubs, and another chapter about vegetables. All of this is good information, and by itself, each of these little pieces is great, but because they tie it all together with that focus on the soil food web and really getting success in your garden, so much of this basic information that you might already be doing but not fully understand why you're doing it, you can find the answers in here. This isn't a long book, it's just a couple hundred pages, but by the time you get to the end, you'll be a believer of how important it is to improve your soil and the importance of the soil food web. The last chapter, no one ever fertilized an old growth forest. They point out how nature does it. A lot of gardeners think that they need fertilizer. They need additives. Well, by the time you finish this book, you realize you really don't. As long as you have organic matter in your soil and that you're encouraging the soil food web and all of those organisms to grow, you'll realize how easy it can be to have really nice, good, rich soil. And I particularly like the appendix. It's called The Soil Food Web Gardening Rules. And the authors give 19 rules to consider when you're working to improve the soil food web. The first, some plants prefer soils dominated by fungi, others prefer soils dominated by bacteria. Did you know that there are different types of soil? Some soils are fungally dominant, other soils are bacterial dominant. You'll know all about this by the time you finish the book. Adding compost and its soil food web to the surface of the soil will inoculate the soil with the same soil food web. I talk a lot about amending the soil, but as they point out, you can take those beneficial organic materials, put them on top of the soil, and when you have a healthy environment, that can be just as good as incorporating it. If you wet and grind mulch thoroughly, it speeds up bacterial colonization. Coarse, drier mulches support fungal activity. These are probably things you haven't heard before, but they're important things to consider because we all like to talk about compost and mulch and whether we do it or we don't do it and how it works in our garden. Well, now you can understand some of the science behind it and really understand why these activities that we're doing, why making compost, why amending the soil, and why adding mulches on a regular basis really will lead to garden success. I'll put a link to Teeming with Microbes in the description below. It's pretty clear that I love this book, and I suspect that if you get it, you'll love it too. It was really a joy to pick it up again, look through the book, see some pictures and diagrams, and read some things that seem like they were new information that I can use again in the upcoming gardening season. Consider getting it for yourself and maybe consider suggesting it to someone in your life for them to get it for you. Regardless, this is one of the best gardening books. And this video is just one in a series of other videos where I point out other books that I also think are among the best that you should consider putting in your library. And you can look at some of those videos next. I'm Gardner Scott. Enjoy gardening.